We're getting tattoos today. Everybody. Ready to get tatted?
Hey.
Where you gonna get your shit hit at?
You getting tattooed?
Huh? You getting your tattoo today? Do or go home. Which one is it? Ready for your tattoo? On the hand?
Yeah.
Ooh, that's gonna be it right there.
That's gonna
be hard. That man kinda look like my hand.
Cause you're my twin.
Ah, twin. Ready to get tatted, Kai?
Now let's talk about the rapper Blueface. Now I know a lot of you guys refer to him as a colorist and y'all not a fan of his, but I ain't even gonna lie to you, this man got a couple bops that I like, but this ain't about me and a couple little bops that I like when I want to be ratchet driving a car down the street, you know. You know, every now and then I like to be ratchet, damn it. Anyway, Blueface is in hot water because he was online telling girls that they either got to get tatted or they got to take their ass on. You gonna take my mark, my mark of the beast, you gonna take my stamp, you tramp, or you gots to go, you gots to go, damn it.
Pretty much irrelevant. I'm just gonna say a few words of, I don't have to be considered a real bitch in your eyes for not dedicating some of my skin to Blue GC. I know I was a part of the show. I'm still grateful for being a part of the show, but honestly, that's just not me. And I didn't fold under pressure. Folding under pressure would have been getting a tattoo after meeting you for 5 days just because you told me to. Yeah. I still don't have no fucking hate towards you though, bro. I already said it was no problem with the people who got the tattoo. Like, I just didn't want it. That's just what it was. And I shouldn't be guilted into feeling bad for not getting it or feeling like I'm lame or feeling like I'm just not a real bitch. I guess I'm not built for that BGC life. I came there for an opportunity of a lifetime, which it was, and I still appreciate the opportunity you gave to me. But I don't have to get a tattoo to be considered real in your eyes. And if that makes the bar of real, then the bar is set real low, because anybody can get a tattoo, anybody. And yeah, so I wish y'all all the best.
And then y'all is comparing him to R. Kelly and just about everybody else that ain't done the same thing in this industry, because this is exactly what this industry is made upon. Getting marked, being a slave, getting holed out, slutted out, and sent on your way and used for content that you are not going to get paid off of later and that you will regret later in your 30s and your damn 40s. Now, with that being said, I'm here to let you know that, you know, I went over to Blueface's OnlyFans for research purposes only. He got a OnlyFans called like Blue GC or whatever, and it's basically him in one of his homes. He packs a bunch of girls in there like sardines. He make them fight. He take them to the strip club. They strip. They get naked. It's a whole lot going on over there on that OnlyFans. Now, one thing I will tell you guys is that although I didn't see any like man on woman sex going on, you see more like just girl on girl, like foreplay, I guess you can say. If you think that these girls are in this house and they not being ran and ain't nothing going on and he ain't sleeping with none of them and he ain't got a bottom bitch that really stay by his side or a mother mistress or a head mother that comes in and really runs and gathers all the girls, then you are absolutely naive and very mistaken.
Want to know what? No, I am going to leave.
So, I'm here to let you guys know that in my humble opinion, Blueface is running the whole house. He is a pimp, in my opinion, and he is no different than the R. Kelly's of the world, the Chris Browns of the world, or damn it, the Hugh Hefner's of the world. Here are my comparisons between Blueface's house, trafficking, etc. Alright, number one, the girls are kept into cramped quarters and pretty pretty much laid on top of one another. This is something that is very frequent in cat houses, pretty much around the damn country. They'll find a space, you know, renovated to their liking, and then they just stuff the girls in as needed because they basically are there to do one thing, all right, or maybe many things. And if and like I said before, I don't know this for a fact, but I can pretty much infer that not only are the girls there for him to make money off them as far as content, he's also going to make money off of them because his friends are going to pay to come by and smash, as well as industry men are going to come by and smash. This is literally the modern day version of the Playboy Mansion. It just, it is what it is. Number two, the girls have to be branded. Girls being branded, this is going to show that on the streets, in public, wherever they go, that they are one of his girls. No matter, and it's permanent, damn it. So no matter how far they get along in life, no matter after they leave his house, no matter after they think they done broke this brainwashing, every time they look at their hand, their neck, their chest, wherever they going to get stamped at, they are reminded that they were wants his property and that really he will always own them. Now, we remember one girl that got his government name tattooed on her. The other girl that she had like her teeth knocked out and she was getting his name tatted on her face. Like, these girls are seriously sick. But in order to show ownership over any girl, any hoe, whatever, and to make sure that she ain't picked up by another pimp out there, you have to brand her so that the streets know she belongs to you. It's simple branding. Same thing people do with cattle. Same things the slave masters did with slaves. Well, yeah, this is modern day slavery, by the way, just letting you know. Number three, the girls fight over him and his attention because he is the pimp. And so really the high spot can be, you know, they can call it the bottom bitch, which is what Jocelyn is calling it over there on her show. Or, you know, the main girl, whatever they calling it. Because I can pretty much guarantee you there is a head mother to come in, you know, and that's pretty much a girl that a grown seasoned woman now that's not necessarily being picked to be a hoe no more, but she already know the streets. She know how to gather the girls. She physically intimidating and she can keep them together, and she's probably going to get a cut out of whatever the girls make for Blueface, because Blueface also has to make sure that the hoes ain't cutting him out of his damn check. It's a whole system to it, but they are all fighting to be next to him, to be the main girl, to probably have a baby for him, to for him to, you know, rescue them out of that lifestyle, to actually marry them. Just like Holly Madison over there at the Playboy Mansion thought that Hugh Hefner was really finna marry her ass.
Well, Holly is the lady that I have publicly said in the past is the love of my life and that I expected to spend the rest of my life with. As John Lennon said some time ago, life is what happens while you're making plans. Holly wanted very much to get married and have children, and that wasn't in the card for us.
And then years later, after she abided her, now she want to write a book about, you know, how he was so disgusting and this and then the third, but you weren't saying that when you was trying to be that old man's. When you're trying to be that old man's wife, let's just call it what it is. Now, moving right along for that, last but not least, the girls pose nude. They pose nude on the OnlyFans. That's content that's sold. That's no different than how the Playboy Mansion had the girls posing nude and those pictures were sold. They might have been given a little check, a little cash, but the money that that Hugh Hefner made off of those girls posing naked, pictures that are out there forever, is in no comparison to what those models were paid to model. And a lot of times, those girls were not even of age, but that's a whole nother conversation for another day. We're going to hope that Blueface is smart enough to not have no underage girls up in this ish, and I'm gonna hope that NDAs have been signed. I'm gonna hope that these girls are all here on their free will. But come on now, let's just keep it real. There is really nobody that is in their right mind and a healthy and functional woman, person, man, whatever, that's gonna sign up to be in these living conditions to be prostituted out. Nobody wakes up and says, "Hey, I want to be a prostitute to a rapper that has no rhythm." Like, nobody's gonna do that. So at the end of the day, you know, 10-15 years from now, I do believe we will be watching a surviving Blueface documentary. The girls are gonna say they were forced to do it or coerced, and that's what he has to realize too, that even though he ain't telling them they gotta do it, forcing them they gotta do it, he's saying get tatted or go home, which means you either get down with me and let me brand you forever, or I'ma just send your ass packing. And let's keep it real, he know damn well he ain't even probably flying these girls on Southwest. These girls probably being put on Greyhound buses, or they being flown on Spirit of Frontier. And everybody know that Spirit of Frontier is where you send Where you send people that you really don't care if they actually make it to their destination or not. No shade, but it's very
true. What's up, my Curry Gang / Night and Day family? If you like the original transparent glasses / face shields, then you will love these new and improved face shield glasses even better. With more colors to choose from, this shield is longer and wider. Pause. The nose piece is designed differently so it doesn't easily slide off, and the view is much clearer. We've also noticed minimum to no fog. These shields have been tested by our Night and Day team, and we think you will love them just as much as we do. The link to the glasses is in the description box below, so go get yourself some at nightanddaynetmarket.com.
It's Storm Show. Ay, it's Storm Show.